Again, a very good evening to everyone. Thanks for joining the session today. So without, let's start the session now. So I request our trainer, Viswanath sir, to start the session without any delay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Johnny. So, am I audible for everyone? Can you give me
Yes,
on a
sir, you're audible.
chat? Yeah, great, great. Thanks. So let me share my screen first of all. Okay. Oh, people are joining still. Okay. Great. So are you guys able to see my screen? Can you confirm? Johnny?
Yes, sir, it's visible, sir. It's crystal
Okay,
clear.
great. Great. So first let me introduce myself. Okay, my name is Chintakindi Vishwanath and I'm ethical hacker, certified ethical hacker and a cybersecurity trainer. And I have a 9+ years of experience in this cybersecurity and have given many trainings and workshops for a corporate as well as individual too. And the certifications you can able to see. And I work with IBM as well as we have a coordination with the Telangana State Police Academy also. So the brief introduction about me. Okay. So before going into this ethical hacking and cyber security, can you, anyone tell me when you hear a word called hacking, what comes into your mind? Just a small interaction. Okay. So when you hear a word called hacking, what comes into your mind? Just if you want, you can raise your hand so that I can so that Johnny can unmute yourself. Unmute. If anyone wants to share your experience. Yes, to access data from other persons. Okay. Any other things? Any other? When you hear a word called hacking. Okay, another question. Whether hacking is a legal or illegal one? Can anyone raised surrender ready and yes, it depends. Oh, Manish, money, it depends, legal and illegal, both. Okay, great. So here the first thing you need to remember, hacking, you are learning not a hacking, you are learning a ethical hacking and cyber security. Okay, so here we'll go today, we'll have a small demo on theoretical part, like what is hacking, how many types of hackers are available, okay, and what is the life cycle of a hacking. Then we'll go into a small introduction about what are the scope of ethical hacking and what salaries will be available in a corporate if you do this certification and a course. Then skills required for a hacking. These things we'll discuss today. Okay. And if you have any doubts, at the end of the session, we have a QA session. There you can ask me questions over there. So first, we'll go with the definition of a hacking. So the process of attempting to gain successful unauthorized access to a target. Target might be anything. Either it may be a system, either it may be a computer or an email ID, whatever it might be, even a mobile phone also. So whatever the process he's doing, a person is doing, whatever the process he is doing to gain unauthorized access, that process we call it as a hacking. Okay, so hacking is a technique in which anyone can access anyone's computer without his permission. The line which I have written here, he is purely depending upon a situation. Remember that hacking is a technique in which anyone can access anyone's computer without his permission. That is true as well as false. Both conditions false. So you need to know when it will become a true, when it will become a false. When you find any loophole or a weakness, okay, of a particular target, then it becomes a true. For example, if I want to hack a particular person, okay, a particular person called Venkat, okay, email ID, or otherwise a system of a Venkat. So what happens? So first I will try to find a vulnerability in his system, then it becomes true because anyone can access anyone's computer without his permission if vulnerability exists, if loophole is existed, weakness is existed. If there is no weakness or a loophole is not there and everything is protected, then it comes under false. Okay, so just have a glance of this. Like just when you hear a word called hacking, unauthorized access, that's it. Unauthorized access to any target, but that should be having a loophole. Okay. Now we'll see then what is a ethical hacker. See, we discussed about what is hacking, that is unauthorized access. But what is the course you are learning? Ethical hacking. right? Ethical hacking and ethical hacker, right? So who is ethical hacker then? Ethical hacker means the person who attacks a security system on behalf of owner, and he find the vulnerabilities of that particular target, and he will give that report. Okay, he will report that vulnerabilities to a concerned person. So that is the job of ethical hacker. Okay, the name only tells you ethical means. Ethical means you should follow some protocols, rules and regulations, right? So without permission, he won't touch that particular target. Example, if you take me as an example, I'm an ethical hacker. So if I want to test a particular website, okay, whether it is hackable or not, whether it is having any issues or not, so I can't do directly on that, but I can't do attacks on that website directly. First, we'll take a permission from the owner and we'll try to attack on that website. Once you attack on that website, we'll find a vulnerabilities. Okay, this is a way we can enter into a website. So that comes under vulnerability. So we'll write a report on that. Okay, see, sir, this is a way we entered and this is the problem. This is the issues we occurred. So you have to patch this. Otherwise, other people can also enter into your website and they can do malicious activity, right? So this is a job profile of an ethical hacker. Okay, that comes under penetration testing. We call it as a, in our corporate terminology, we call this testing as a penetration testing. Okay, so with permission, we are going to do. Without permission, we are not going to touch that particular target. If it is a criminal hacker, like whatever the news you are hearing, right, the media and whatever. So those people, they are not going to take any permission. They are directly attacking on a website and they are going to exploit that vulnerabilities, exploit that vulnerabilities. Okay, so this is a difference. So the difference, hacker versus ethical hacker. Hacker without authorization, he will do and he breaks the law. Okay, he breaks the law. Okay, and ethical hacker with the same activities he's going to do, ethical hacker also, but with owner's permission. With owner's permission. And these people will be employed by any companies to perform penetration testing. Remember that penetration testing. In our terminology, we call it as the testing. What we are going to do, that is a penetration testing. And here, one more thing you need to remember: when you go for any technical discussions or interviews on these particular security modules or a security ethical hacking, the general first thing is they are going to test your general knowledge. Example: if I take a simple example question, which was you can expect in your future also. See, whatever the course you learn, there will be a designation with that particular course. For example, if you learn a Java, you will apply for a Java developer, and there is a designation called Java developer. If you learn a website designing, there is a web developer job, right? If you learn any cloud computing technologies, right? So there will be a cloud engineer, right? AWS engineer or Azure engineer. But if you learn ethical hacking, there is no job designation. There is no designation with the ethical hacker or ethical hacking. Right, so if you go and search on these jobs like ethical hacking and ethical hacker, you won't find any jobs apart from this name. They are going to give you some cybersecurity analyst, information security analyst, or a penetration tester. Okay, these type of designations they are going to give you. So what is the difference? Why they are not giving with the name of hacking? Means the first thing, hacking is an offensive word that should not be used in a designations as per rules. So that's why they are not using this particular name hacking in a designation. Apart from that, they are going to give you another designation, but the work profile will be the same thing. Okay, so we'll discuss that in next upcoming slides. Okay, what will be the work profile and what is the scope of ethical hacking and everything. Okay, so now these are the types of hackers you need to remember. Okay, it's a basic thing. White hat, black hat, and gray hat. I think most of the people know about this white, black, and gray, but just I'm giving a basic thing today for a demo. So white hat is nothing but ethical hackers. Remember, white hat is a ethical hackers. They will use their skills. Okay, they will use their skills for protecting us from crime. Okay, and they will try to protect us. They will try to protect our data, our corporate data. If you're working for a company, your job is to protect the data, right? And those people like ethical hackers will try to create awareness for a people, okay, on cyber crimes. Okay, and they don't use their skills for illegal activities. Only legally they are going to do that. Okay, everything will be legal way. Okay, that comes under white hat. Next one is a black hat. Black hat hackers is quite opposite to white. Remember, black hat hackers is quite opposite to white, and whatever the media which is projecting like a cyber crimes, that comes under black hat only. So they will use their skills for illegal activities, for personal gain. So you'll see many these cybercrime news, right? Like OLX frauds or as a phone pay amount was detected and some bank accounts was hacked. And recently, like so many McDonald's information was leaked, right? McDonald's users information was leaked. All these comes under black hat hacking. Means without permission, they are going to hack into other websites or other personal data, and they are going to take that information and they are going to sell that information also. Okay, that for personal gain. So this comes under black hat hacking. When you go with the gray hat hacking, it's a combination of white as well as a black, depending upon the situation they are going to act. See, sometimes the person may act as a white, some person, the same person may act as a black hat hacking also. Okay, example, if you take a simple scenario, if you're working for a company, then you will be behaving like a white hat only, right? Because it's your job to protect that particular organization data. Okay, but when it comes to your personal life, for example, so if you want to hack your girlfriend mail ID, then what happens? Otherwise a boyfriend mail ID also. Okay, so at that time, what your mind will say? You should be like a black hat hacker, right? So it's purely depending upon a situation, how they're going to act. But don't go into black hat hacking because you have to face consequences. Okay, that is an illegal activity. So our main role, our main goal is to teach you white hat hacking. Okay, you need to be an ethical hacker. Okay, and here, the whatever you are learning here, types of hackers like white, black, and gray, those we defined for our purpose based on the activities a person does, right? So this is only for theoretical purpose we are having like white, black, and gray. But when you go into real world of cyber world, there is no white, black, and gray. Remember, hacker is a hacker, that's it. Okay, there is no white, there is no black, there is no gray. Simple, simple terminology. Hacker is a hacker, and you should never trust anyone in this field. Remember, okay, you should never trust anyone in this particular cybersecurity field. So next one, why do people hack, right? It's a general question. Why do you want to learn hacking, or why do you want to do hacking? So it's a general question. So I have noted down some of them. Okay, as per my knowledge, it's an individual thought, individual thing for their person to person. It will be varying. Okay, out of that, I have written some of that, like to make security stronger of that particular network, their own network. They will learn ethical hacking to protect. Some people will learn for just for fun or some passion, interest to on this particular technology. And apart from that, some people will learn to steal the information also. So that comes under black hat hacking, but you should be never going into that field. Okay. And destroys enemy's computer during a network war. This will be discussed in later classes. Okay, like what is a cyber war and where you can see the cyber war, how it is going to be done. So we'll discuss that in the next upcoming classes. Just remember that to destroy enemy's computer network during a war. Okay, next. Here is a hacking process. To learn anything, there is some process, right? What not only hacking, whatever the course you learn, whatever the topic you learn, there will be some process. In the same way, hacking also, we are going to have the same five stages. Wait a second. So these are the five stages. First one starts with a footprinting module. Okay, footprinting is nothing but information gathering about a particular target. It's very, very important to know this particular footprinting, because most of the questions what I'm going to get here, in general, sir, I have a phone number of my friend. Can you hack my friend's mobile? Or if I have an email ID, can I hack that password? So is that much easy to hack into accounts? No. Without knowing any information, you can't do hacking first thing. Okay. So here, footprinting is information collecting. So there are so many various ways where you can collect the information about a particular target, either it may be a website or a system or a particular individual person also. Okay, for example, if I take a website example, so what things can I gather? What is the website name? what is IP address, where it was hosted, what technology they have used to develop a website, okay, like a web development, and is there any SSL certificate for that, okay, and like is there where the servers are available, which port numbers are opened, okay, all these information we are going to gather about a particular target. We have so many resources, free resources. We are going to use that free resources to gather information. So almost 80% of success rate will be based on footprinting only. Once you collect all the enough information about a target as much as possible, then we'll go to second phase, that is a scanning module. In this scanning module, what we are going to do here is, whatever the information we gathered, based on that, we'll scan a target. Will scan a particular target to know the vulnerabilities of a particular website. Vulnerabilities, nothing but possible ways to enter into network. So loopholes, weaknesses. Okay, if a developer has done any mistake, okay, then that is called as a loophole or a vulnerability. So by that, a hacker can enter into a website. So scanning module will give you all the vulnerabilities and extra information which is available on servers, okay, vulnerabilities. So the possible ways to enter into network. Third phase is an enumeration phase. In this enumeration phase, we are going to launch attacks based on the scanning module, based on the report, whatever we got, based on the vulnerabilities, we'll try to launch an attack on a particular target. And if attack was successful, then that comes under fourth stage. That is attack and gaining access. If attack is successful, you will gain access to that particular website or a network, and you can log in as an administrator. You can log in as administrator of that particular website, and you can a hacker will do whatever he wants to do. But there is a limitations for ethical hacker, right? So once you attack and once the attack was successful, then you are going to report that. That is a job of ethical hacker. But if he is a malicious hacker, black hat hacker, he is not going to report that. He is going to take advantage of that particular login, and he will do some modifications, deletions, whatever he want. Okay. So then the fifth stage is covering of tracks. Covering of tracks is nothing but whenever you try to log in into a website, there will be a storage which will log your IP address, MAC address, and what is your username, all this stuff, right? So proof. So covering of tracks is nothing but deleting all that proofs. Okay, all that proofs, like clearing the traces of that particular attack. Okay, deleting a log files, deleting the information, all which is related to attack. Okay, that comes under covering of tracks, because there should be no proof. A black hat hacker will take care about these things. Like there should be no proof that I have entered into network. So they will delete all the information. Next, creating a backdoors. It's very important. Black hat hacker will leave a virus into that particular website before leaving that particular website, because for the further use. For example, after 6 months, again, I want to hack a same website. Okay, XYZ website, same website. So there might be possible or may not be possible to log in, because once the attack was done, they will take their own security modules, right? They will improve their security. So they may not log in. The hackers may not log in. So to avoid that, they will leave a virus in that website. And after 6 months, if the still virus existed on that website, he can directly enter through that website, through that virus into a website. Okay. So this is a life cycle. When you compare the same thing, just now we discussed everything with the technical stuff, right? So some people may not understand this technical stuff, some confusing. So to make it very clear, I will compare the same process with your general life so that you will be very easy for you to understand. Okay. So like think that a website is a home, a hacker is a thief, and a watchman. We can call the watchman as a antivirus or a firewalls. Okay. So if a thief wants to enter into home, what he's going to do? He won't directly enter into home, right? First of all, he will collect the information about a home, like how many people will be there in home and when they are coming in, going out, and is there any CCTV cameras are there or not? Okay, all the stuff they are going to gather. That is footprinting module. When you go with second module, scanning. So he will look for a possible ways to enter. When is the flexible time to enter into home? Like if there is no watchman, he can enter into that home. He will look for all the possible ways. If there is no CCTV cameras, okay, that is one of the flexible. If there is no one at home, if the home is locked, then that is also one of the flexible. If there is our only children are at home, That is also one of the possible way. So he will look for all the possible ways to enter into home. That comes under scanning module. Third phase, launching of attacks. So to enter into home, what is going to do? He will try to enter into home by breaking the lock, or he will use some duplicate keys, or he will do some activity over there, right, to enter into home. So that comes under enumeration phase. That is a launching of attacks. Okay. After that, fourth phase is a attack and gaining access. So once he gain access, attack was successful, and once he entered into home, he should maintain that particular access. Okay, he should maintain that access, and whatever the malicious activity he is going to do, like stealing the gold, money, whatever he want, blah blah things, he will do that, right? Activity is going to be done over there. After that, he is going to escape from homes, right? Once his work is done, he is going to escape from home. Before escaping, what he's going to do, he will clear all his fingerprint, footprints, and everything. Otherwise, he will take care about wearing a gloves and everything, right? So that comes under covering of tracks. And before escaping, okay, so he will look for a back doors. Okay, from where can I escape? Because he entered from a front door, but from escaping, he will look for a back doors. Okay, that comes under backdoor. So this is a life cycle where you can compare with your general life. So whatever the cause, not only this process, if you want to learn any concept, we have to assume like this so that you can get a clear picture and you can easily learn the topic on this. Okay, so I hope this is clear for you, whatever the topic which I have explained with a general example. Okay, so now we'll see what is the scope of ethical hackers in corporate world. There is a huge scope for an ethical hackers in a corporate, not only corporate, everywhere. Ethical hackers are responsible for identifying the vulnerabilities and security flaws, and they are going to they will work with the organization to make the security very strong. Okay, that is one of the job role for an ethical hackers. Even startup companies are also right now looking for an ethical hackers to secure their data. Okay, so it's a responsibility to report and analyze the risk assessment, like malware analysis or a protocol analysis, application analysis, whatever it might be. And many of the people right now, they are shifting their career to ethical hacking because it's an evergreen subject, where you can take evergreen subject, because it's like an ocean. You can learn many things in this particular course. Okay, so if you want to become an ethical hackers, there is a certification called from EC Council, that is a certified ethical hackers. So you can obtain for that particular certification and you can apply for a jobs. Okay, so there is a huge scope. Even startup companies are also looking for an ethical hackers. When you go with the career path, sir, I have done the ethical hacking course and cybersecurity course, and I don't know which designations can I apply. What is a career path for this ethical hackers? Means this is a slide for that. Okay, so what are the career opportunities if you learn CEH, Certified Ethical Hacking? Means you can go as an ethical hacker, nothing but a CEH. You can go for a network security engineer. You can apply for that. If you are very interested in network, to protect a network, then you can go for network security engineer. If you want to do computer forensics investigator, that will be useful for you can work with the government also. Computer forensics, cyber crime investigations, we can go with that. Then security auditor. So auditing purpose also, they are going to use the CEH people, because for every quarterly or halfly, they are going to do all the security audits. Okay, at that time also the security, the CEH people are very important. Data security analyst, it's very important, data security. To secure the particular data, you should have a knowledge of CEH. And next is information security officer. It's like a manager post, okay? So you will be handling a group of people under you, and you need to guide them. So that is a job role. Okay, so all these are the career paths where you can apply for this once you're done with this course. And here the one thing, we are going to give you everything on live attacks. We are going to show you everything on live, because if you want to learn ethical hacking and if you want to secure your network or secure your computers, first you need to know how hacking works, then only you can secure yourself, right? Simple example, if you want to catch a thief, a police wants to catch a thief, the police also thinks like a thief. Then only he can investigate a case, right? The same thing happens here. If you want to protect yourself, first you need to know how hacking works, how hacker is going to do attacks. Then you can mitigate that attack. Okay, you can mitigate that attack, or you can counter to that particular attack. That is the main intention. But don't, it's an educational purpose only. We are going to show you all the attacks, but don't take it in a wrong way and do it on your real-time thing, because you may get into trouble. So please, because I have seen many cases on that. Okay, so please be careful on that. Next one is the salaries in cybersecurity. How much salary you can expect? Right, the first question, sir, I have learned this course and I apply for this course. What is the minimum salary expectation for cyber security or ethical hacker? Means minimum package for a freshers are also included with 5 lakhs package. Minimum 5 lakhs package, average package, that will be average base salary of 5 lakhs package is for a cyber security. Okay, once you're done with your courses and once you are increasing your knowledge, like level 1, level 2, level 3, something like that, then you can expect more salary and the maximum unlimited. You can take it as a maximum as unlimited, and you can choose this career in a corporate. Otherwise, you can use this knowledge as a freelancing also. There is a possibility where you can work as a freelancer for many companies. To do when like going for a security consultant. Okay, you can go as a security consultant, as a freelancer job is also available. So it's your thing which one you want to select. Okay, so there are two ways: professional, which you want to go for a job. Otherwise, you can use as a freelancing also. Okay. Next one is skills required to learn ethical hacking. It's a $1 million question. Many questions I'm going to get these questions, I hope. So I want to learn ethical hacking. So what is the knowledge? Is there any programming knowledge which is required, right? Otherwise, what prerequisite sites to learn this ethical hacking? Yes. The first thing here is basics of networking knowledge. Okay, you need to have a basics of networking knowledge. If you are not from a technical background, don't worry about that. We are going to teach you that networking stuff. It's very important. So we'll go with networking basics starting. Then we are going to use Windows and Linux as well as, okay, so in a basics of computer knowledge, like how to use a Windows and how to use a Linux and all the stuff, that's more than enough basic knowledge. Okay, so don't worry about all these knowledges. We are going to give you some resources where you can learn this basic knowledge. Okay, and basics of programming, like HTML, PHP, and MySQL, because we are going to do a penetration testing on websites also. So if you have a basic knowledge, like what is HTML, and if you see the code and if you able to understand the code, that's more than enough, because we are not developers. We are not going to do any developing applications. We are going to test that application. So we don't have any from scratch. We are not going to do anything. Okay. Just if you see the code, that's more than enough. If you are able to understand, that's more than enough. Okay. And next is a problem solving skills. Okay. That is the one thing you need to have. All right. These are the technical, and other than that, we have a non-technical skills is required. That is, self-learning is very, very important. If you have a passion, if you have an interest, then you can do this self-learning. Okay. And to learn this course, you should have a patience to learn this course. Important thing. Because it's not that much easy. Like within one night, you can't get all the knowledge on this ethical hacking. Okay. So you should be very patient, and you have to practice. Okay, then only you can get more things. Okay, next is, irrespective of any degree, you can opt for this, whatever the degree you are going to have. Like there is no special degree, like you need to go with only BTech. BTech people can only do this particular course. There is no something like that. Any degree can be opt for this particular course. Okay, these are the skills required for an ethical hacking. So this is for the demo, which I want to explain you. And over to you, Johnny. If you want to explain anything, you can explain over there. After that, I will show you the course curriculum and a question session, QA session.
Thanks a lot, sir. That was a wonderful session by you. And now I'll be sharing the details about the course provided by Steady Comrade on ethical hacking. So please be patient. So I'll be telling about the course. So hope my screen is visible to everyone. So Can I know, is it visible in your start session, please? Keep yes if my screen is being visible to you. Yes, thank you, Surendranath and Haripriya. Thanks for your immediate response. And yes, our Steady Combat is providing courses on different technologies, but as of now, we are providing courses on web development, ethical hacking, and data analytics. So how the course works in Steady Comrade? So you might be saying that there are many platforms which are providing ethical hacking. So what's specialty? What's the novelty in Steady Comrade? In Steady Comrade, you can do any course with your friends. Yes, you heard correct. Now you can pursue any course and you can master any technology along with your friends together. We know what the result before an exam if we study with our friends. We can grasp and we can learn anything easily if we do with our friends. And that's our main motive. So now you can pursue any course and master any course along with your friends. And the ethical hacking course will be dealt by Viswanath sir, who just gave his wonderful webinar. And the course starts from November 25th. And what are the things you'll be getting if you do a course in Steady Comrade? Yeah, attend the live sessions with your gang and gain knowledge. And it will be like learning by doing. You will be learning the things and you'll be doing at the particular time. Parallelly, both the things will be done in Steady Comrade. And what's the end? At the end, you'll be provided with a real-time project and internship opportunity too. So yes, what's the timing? You might be thinking that I am having the college, so how can I handle? So because you no need to have that doubts. So completely the course will be in the free times. The course will be in the evening times. The course timings will be from 6 to 8 p.m. In between 6 to 8 p.m., it will be 1 hour, 15 minutes. It's exactly not 6 to 6:45. It's just for a reference. The course timings will be in between the 6 to 8 p.m. In between the 6 to 8 p.m., you will be having regular classes from 1 hour, 15 minutes. And first 45 minutes will be the live class. As I said, it will be live class. And last half an hour will be group discussions. You will be provided with the virtual rooms where you will be having only your friends. You will be discussing what are the concepts have discussed in that particular class. And if you are having any doubts, the instructor will come into your virtual room, and he'll be clearing all your doubts. We'll be providing personal assistance too. Yes, it will be like learning by doing. As I said, at the end of any course, you will be provided with the real-time project and you'll be given paid internship too. Note this point, you will be provided with you will be learning with your friends together. You'll be having fun time learning live classes, and you'll be very feasible in your feasible timings, along with that paid internship offer and real-time project too. And yeah, what's the duration of the course? Actually, it's not 80 days. For ethical hacking, it's only 60 days. So you'll be completing the whole course and you'll be suggested by the Viswanath sir how to be an ethical hacker and what are the formalities to complete to become a certified ethical hacker. So now to become a certified ethical hacker, you are just few steps away. I'll be sharing the registration link of the course. Just register for it. After your successful registration, your future is in our hands. And that's a promise. You'll be having a great start to your career. And what are the prizes? I mean, at the end, what you'll be get? As I mentioned, you will be getting the course completion certificate. You'll be getting the project completion certificate. At the same time, parallelly, you'll be provided with a paid internship offer. And now let's come to the main point. So what's the cost? Actually, for the same courses, for the same offers, for the internship offer, for the real-time projects, other edtech platforms are, demanding some lakhs and thousands of money, but in Steady Comrade, everyone can pursue a course at less than their party price. So as I said, you can do any course with your friends along. So if you take solo, a few of the students wish to study alone, so for them also we are providing the feasibility to go alone, but the cost of the price is $15.99, as you see in the last column. But if you want to do with your friends, if you want to do with your one friend, if you want to pursue the course with three or four, we are providing up to five people. So if we do the course along with your friends, the cost of the price actually decreases. Per head, you only have to pay $12.99. If you are doing with the three of your friends, $12.99. If three, $12.99. If four, up to five members, is $12.99 only. But if you want to go alone, the price is $15.99. So you are getting the real-time offer, studying along with your friends, internship offer, personal assistance. Now you no need to pay thousands and lakhs of money to build your dream career because Steady Combat is now with you. You're just few clicks away to build your dream career as a certified ethical hacker. And as I mentioned you earlier, we feel like once you obtain the knowledge, no one can stop you from achieving what you want. So don't rethink, just register for the course. And we all know there is a reason why you go to Goa with your gang. If it is not Goa, we know. While having fun time with our friends, it gives a great experience. I mean, it's not only about the parties. Take your friends along with you and have learning and growing together. So not only in parties, now in gaining knowledge and building your career, let the friends also be part in your successful journey. So that's our main motto. And I'm just giving the registration link, course registration link in the chat box session. And as I mentioned earlier, whatever the prizes that I have mentioned in the above slide, so these prizes are only valid till tonight. I mean, till 12 PM tonight. These prizes are just valid till 12 AM tonight. If you once visit our official website, the prizes are too high, double than this. As you are the participants, as you have attended today's webinar, we are only offering this discount price to you people till today night 12. Okay, so use this discount opportunity and try to build a career with your friends. Now, if you are having any doubts regarding the webinar, sir, Viswanath sir will be clearing the doubts. And if you are having any doubts regarding the course prizes or anything else, I'm here to clear the doubts. So over to you guys. So Gnaneshwar, please unmute all. So if you are having any type of doubts, we are here to clear all the doubts. Thank you. Viswanath sir, now please present the course content.
Yeah, so this was a course content we are going to present in this course. It will be purely on EC Council syllabus, so that will be useful for you to do certification, CES certification. If you want, you can go, once you're done with this course, you can go for a CES certification. We will help you on that certification also, don't worry on that. So I will give you a guidance on that. So we'll start with the networking basics, introduction of ethical hacking and networking basics. Then we'll go into step-by-step process, like how the flowchart flows, footprinting module, scanning. Then we'll go with enumeration, like launching of attacks over there. Then we'll go into vulnerability analysis. These are the topics, like where we are going to see how to do risk assessment and vulnerability analysis on applications and all those stuff. Then we'll go into sniffing and sniffers, nothing but a man-in-middle attacks, how hackers will hack into your network and how they can see your data. Okay, so that can also be done. I will show you that everything on live, don't worry. And system hacking, like how hackers will hack into other systems and how they will hack a web cameras, what are the possible ways and how to mitigate that. Okay, how to counter attack for that particular things. Next is the malware threats. By using malware, how hackers will infect your system and how they will do damage to your system and how they will control their system, how they will control the system also. Okay, so we'll show you that in live, and again we'll show you how to mitigate that attacks. Okay, next is a phishing attack and social engineering, nothing but it's very interesting topic, like how hackers will hack into your Facebook accounts, Instagram and Gmail, whatever it might be. Okay, so I'm going to show you that also, and we'll see how to protect those type of attacks and how can we protect from those type of attacks. Okay, then the DOS attacks is nothing but denial of service attacks. We call it as a denial of service attacks. I will explain that in real time, but it's a very dangerous attack, so you should never perform that in a real time. Okay, whatever I'm going to teach you, I will tell you whether you can practice or not. Okay, if I tell you you can practice, you can do it on your lab system. We are going to create a lab in your machine itself. You can practice at any point of time. Okay, there is no restrictions because the lab is in your machines, physical machines, so you can practice at any time on that. Next is session hijacking. This session hijacking is nothing but hackers will hack into a session by stealing the cookies and they will log in into your accounts. I can give you a live demo on this on like Amazon Prime. Okay, Amazon Prime or a Hotstar, Disney. We have done recently found a vulnerability on this session hijacking. So I can give you a live demo on this also if it is not patched. Okay, if it is not patched within this. So otherwise, I can give you a recorded session also. Okay, don't worry on that. And next is a hacking web servers and web applications. It's very important. Like how hackers will hack into websites without knowing a username and password, and what are the various ways they will use methods to hack into websites. Then SQL injections. SQL, that is nothing but a database. How hackers will hack into databases of a network or a website. We'll show you that in real time on real websites. Don't worry. Can you please go on mute? It's a disturbance. Okay. Now, Wi-Fi hacking. This is very important and very interesting for everyone. Like, so how to hack a Wi-Fi, right? I'm going to show you that Wi-Fi hacking also, how hackers will hack into Wi-Fis by using some adapters, tools, hardware tools we are going to use over there. And I'm going to show you that. And we are going to use some Kali Linux operating system to perform the attacks also, not only Windows, Kali Linux, combination of Windows and Linux systems. And after that, we'll show you what the theoretical part, that is on our firewalls, how many types of firewalls are available and what is the use of a firewalls and all those things. Then IoT and cloud computing was a newly introduced topic because the technology is going with IoT and cloud computing, right? So there are possibilities where hackers can hack into those things also. So we'll show you some theoretical part on IoT and cloud computing. If possible, I'm doing some practical sessions over there. If it works, I will show you a live attacks also, like CCTV camera and some other things. Okay. And cryptography is nothing but how to encrypt your data, how to secure your data. Okay. So, and stenographies, there will be another topic called stenographies over here. And along with that, I missed one thing, that is Android hacking. Mobile hacking. Okay. So mobile hacking is also going to be there over here. So you can learn how hackers will hack into mobile phones by sending one click. How can he get a pictures of that particular person, selfie cameras. Okay. I'm going to show you that. And along with that, how can hacker control all your mobile? Okay. I'm going to show you that. It's an interesting topic, Android hacking. Next is a penetration testing, nothing but how to write a report, how to submit a report, and where you can submit a reports for major companies like Microsoft, Google, if you find any vulnerabilities on those websites. So where you can report those things, like it comes under a freelancing job also. Okay, bug bounty, we call it as a bug bounty. So there I'm going to show you how can you write a report, how report is going to look like, and then we'll show you some platforms where you can register for that and you can go for a bug bounty. Okay, when you find any bug, they will give you a bounty for that. Okay, a token of appreciation. So that will be covered in all this course content. Okay, and these are the topics which we are going to cover in a course. So right now I'm open to any questions I can answer. Any questions?
So actually few of our participants joined in the middle. So few of them want to know about your experience, sir, actually. So once, please tell about your experience and your profile.
Oh, okay. Profile. Okay. So this was my profile. I am Chintakindi Vishwanath. I am a certified ethical hacker and cybersecurity trainer. And I have a 9+ years of experience in this ethical hacking and cybersecurity, like organizing and trained many students as well as corporate professionals too. And previously, I worked with IBM. And right now I'm working with the Telangana State Police Department on cyber crimes also and cyber wing. And I have given many lectures. If you want more about me, just search with my name in Google, you will get whole my profile. Okay. So just with my name in Google, you will get a whole profile about myself. Okay. So this is a basic introduction about me now. And now I'm open to questions, whatever the questions you want to ask, even if it is in scope and out scope, I will feel free to ask questions. So I think you have to unmute the people, Johnny.
Yes, sir, they can speak now.
If you have any access, anyone can unmute them.
So yeah, if you have a doubt, you can unmute yourself. Yes.
Hello. So what type of jobs can we get by learning ethical hacking, sir?
So you can go with the penetration testing. The first job, you can go with the penetration testing. Otherwise, if you have a suggestion, if you want to get into this cybersecurity field, once you're done with this course, you opt for an web penetration testing. It's one of the easiest way to enter into this particular field. Once you enter into this field, you can learn many courses, advanced level courses, and you can go for apply for other jobs like a cybersecurity consultant or a cybersecurity information security analyst. So analyst positions. Okay, the starting will be a penetration testing. Then we'll go with analyst positions. Next.
Sir, once you go through charts, many are asking you.
How do we do pen testing in home router, which information we will gather? So that will be covered in Wi-Fi hacking, where we are going to see how to hack a Wi-Fi, right? Our home router Wi-Fis. So there we are going to collect the information like a MAC address of a router and SSID number and what is the encryptions they are going to have. So we'll try to capture the handshake and we are going to get the passwords of a Wi-Fi. If it is a weak, if a password is in a weak security, then it is very easy. Within few seconds, we can get a password. That can be done. I'm going to show you that on live on Wi-Fi hacking. And Surendra Reddy. Next one, exploit vulnerability like real attacker will do. Yes, we are going to do all on real time only, real attacks only. Why we are going to teach you as a attacker means, if you know how attacker attacks into your machine, you can defend yourself. That's the main ideology. Okay. Next. Manish, gathering information after that, checking vulnerability, then target will be easy to hack. Yes. So first information gathering, then we'll check for a vulnerability, then we'll try to attack based on that vulnerability. So with owner's permission, that's the important thing you note down. So with owner's permission, you are going to do this. It will be very easy for you. Next. That's it. I hope no questions in chat here. So guys, you can ask me out of the box also. Okay. Any questions? So can I know much you have experience in this? How much you have experience? 9+ years. Okay. Officially, unofficially, I can't tell you that. And officially 9+. Okay. And next. Get from learning, what jobs can we apply? Already given the career path, right? What are the jobs you can apply? So like a penetration testing or information security analyst and a security auditor, all those are the things. Sir, all the software doesn't support to run certain interfaces. What about that, sir? Are you going to provide any alternative for that? Yes, we are going to provide you the lab as well as a lab kit also. What are the softwares which I'm going to use in live sessions. Everything I'm going to give you, that particular material also. Material along with the tools. So that you can do it on your virtual machines. Don't do it on your physical machines. The practice should be done on your virtual machines. Okay, I'm going to show you how can you create a virtual machines lab and everything. Yeah, Durga, tell me. Okay. So how can we get a government jobs by this? Government jobs, see, if you have a more experience, you can't expect within as a fresher, you can't expect a government jobs. First thing, okay, if you want to work with a cyber wing, first you need to have a more experience, and then you can have an when you attend for a webinars and seminars, and if you develop your circle contact list, then you may get a chance to work with a cyber wing also. Okay, there is no by only freshers, no freshers, no. There is no possibility. Just you should have an experience, like minimum of 4 to 5 years, so that you can. You need to understand how investigation goes on, how to solve the particular cases, how to trace out a particular person who is a hacker. Then you can explore your knowledge and you can The police people will only identify you and they can give you a chance to work with them. Okay, that is the one thing. Because my personal experience, also the same thing. Because in the starting, I haven't worked with any police department. But after these many years, they only started contacting me. Based on the profile, they started contacting me and I'm working with now those people. Really, it's great to have classes with you, sir. Just now, I saw your profile in internet. Oh, thank you, Sheikh. Okay. So you can get more profile about me. Okay, I have mentioned it's only a basic thing. Sir, are you from... it's out of thing. Yeah. Satish Kumar. Yes, I'm from those... not those thing, those person. But the surname is same. That's it. Okay. Okay, I'm done with my demo, I think. Can we have any chances working with task forces or defense side? It's purely this, just now I told you, right, Narasimha? Like, you should have any more knowledge and the profile should be enhanced, then they will take you. Okay, so freshers, you can't expect. But it will be a very, very good choice to enter into the cyber field. Next. So okay, Johnny, I'm done, I think.
Okay, no sir questions. I hope the participants are having all doubts have been cleared. Now guys, this is a wonderful opportunity for you, so join the course from November 25th. As I mentioned, you now don't miss a great opportunity to get guided by a certified ethical hacker like Viswanath sir. So as I am again pasting the registration post registration link in the comment section, and as I mentioned to you earlier, the discount prices are valid till 12 tonight. So be hurry and register with your friends. And only we are focusing on 50 to 60 students. So beyond that, even if you register successfully, we are not taking into the list. So there are limited seats. So first come first serve. So be quick. And don't miss the chance to get guided by an intellectual like Viswanath sir. So now once you register, your future is in our hands. So build your career together with your friends. So we encourage you to take the course along with your friends. So if you take along with your friends, the pricing will be less, as well as you can have group discussion and fun time learning too, virtually. So if you want to study alone, we are also providing alone, but don't be a minimum guy by studying alone, okay? So register with your friends before tonight, 12 p.m. and save your money and build your career too. Yeah. So if you are having any doubts regarding, anyone can register for the course. If you are PUC, pre-intermediate course, or intermediate student, as sir mentioned, so degree doesn't matter. Ethical hacking is open for all. If you have a strong intention to be an ethical hacker, so you'll be giving everything from the scratch, as sir said. So from scratch, you'll be given everything. So once you register, as I said, your future is in our hand, and that's a promise. So do register for the course. And yeah, I'm open for the doubts. If you're having any doubts regarding the Steady Comrade platform, I'm ready to answer all the questions now. You can use the chat session as well. I mean, chat box as well, if you're having any doubts. So I think you're not having any doubts. So me and my team will be waiting for 5 more minutes here. If you're having any kind of doubts, I'm here. If you're having any doubt regarding the price list, I'll once again presenting my screen. So actually, these are the pricings. If you take along with your friends, it will be like $12.99 per head. If you go by solo, I mean by individual, you will be having to, you need to pay $12.99. And along with the course content, practical sessions, you will be given internship opportunity and you'll be taught how to be a certified ethical hacker and everything. Once you register, it will be given everything. Okay. And Once again, we'd like to thank a lot from our bottom of our heart, sir. We are very happy to have an intellectual and experienced trainer like you, Viswanath, sir. Really, it was a great session. It's
thank
a
you.
great start for our team. We're very happy to have you, sir. Hope we'll be doing these great things in future too.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thanks for today's session. Okay, I'm leaving now. Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir.
Bye.
Yes, now, as I said, if you are still having any doubts regarding the course, how it will be the course, what will be the course, and as I said, the timings of the course are like from in between 6 to 8, 1 hour, 15 minutes will be class. And first 45 minutes will be the live class and last half an hour will be the group discussion and practical session. You will be having separate virtual rooms where you will be allotted to your separate team. You can discuss, you can do whatever the stuff you need there. You can have fun time learning too. And Saturday will be the test day. So where you will be given some serious tests. The top performance will be rewarded every week. The top performance will be rewarded every week. And Sunday will be holiday. Have fun. Yeah. These are about the course. And ethical hacking, it's not 80 days. It's 60 days, actually. 60 days course, actually. At the end of the course, you will be getting all this. So course completion certificate, project completion certificate, and paid internship opportunity too. So now you are getting only all these things at less than your party price at just 12,999, actually. Just 1,299 per head. If you go along with your friends. If you want to do it alone, it's just 1599. So guys, as I mentioned you, these prices are just valid till 12 p.m. So 12 a.m. tonight. So just be hurry. Toolkit provided in this course will remain accessible after the course or on this. Of course, everything, whatever it is provided in the course will be accessible to you lifelong. Okay. Whatever you provide you at the start, it will be with you at the end of your career, after your life too. Okay. So no doubt in that. Any doubts, you can unmute yourself or else use a chat session as well. I hope everything is clear to you now. And as I mentioned you earlier, once you register, your career is in our hands. So definitely you'll have a great start to your career. And if you are not willing to be ethical hacker, it's okay, fine. We are also providing many free webinars and free workshops. Stay connected to our Study Comrades social media accounts. They might have been shared in your respective groups. So, yeah.
Yes, Srinu, the recordings will be shared with you. You can access them anytime after the course.
Immediate after completion of the live class. Yeah, as my teammate Gnaneshwar said, immediate after the completion of every class, the recorded session will be provided to you. Guys, we are open for all the doubts. So just be clear before registering. So once you register, your career is in our hands. So don't hesitate. Don't rethink. Just go for it. Connect with your friends and just register for the course and be a certified ethical hacker in just 2 months. Within 2 months, you can build a career at less than your party price now.
Okay, then we'll be ending the session. In case you have any doubts, you can mail us or reach us by WhatsApp.